DC tech. I never know what parameters to put here. Maybe we should check out. We should check out the specification.
Okay.
Also, please.
Hang on.
Hello.
We are trying to deploy. What was it called again? Through the Honey template and new DAO, one of the people can for BSC. So you like. Where can you find the documentation on the parameters? For example, support required.
Holders, I can put my address.
So we deployed the original thing to be right, the test out, to see if there were bugs and stuff, right?
We are, I didn't understand. No, we are deploying on X-Dive.
I know, but before we did it on Rinkeby, right? Like, I saw lots of messages 2 days ago about, like, the test DAO being deployed on Rinkeby, but I'm not sure if I read it wrong.
Yes. The current one is on Rinkeby.
Mm-hmm.
Before people begin to propose things on conviction voting, we are going to migrate it to X-Dive.
Okay.
With the token balance. The token balance, more or less, the same. We will see. It's just a test. It's really important to be exactly the same values.
Yeah.
It's better to do the test here because everything is already deployed here.
Yeah, makes sense. Yeah. Okay, looks good.
And these are the parameters for conviction voting.
What is the difference?
Well,
it can go out of the
How can I explain? I think that decay is not a very good parameter.
Oh.
The parameter that will be this. Will be half-life, which is the time a proposal needs to reach half of the conviction.
Oh, okay.
And better to define this that way.
Okay. Yeah.
And can get the decay from that. It's like 0.9999799. That's the decay. It's the that you multiply the current conviction in each block. So imagine that you have 100 conviction and you stake tokens. The decay is the speed in which it decays. In each block you are going to have 0.9999799. You are multiplying by 0.99979. That's the idea. But it's not practical to explain that. So the parameter that we are going to use is half-life, and then decay is going to be calculated inside the smart contract. Okay. That we don't know.
So we don't have to apply that.
We have a half time of 0.5 days, and we have to calculate the decay from that. And the way to do that is to use a formula that is that one. 1/2 over convert time. Convert the time is the half life divided by block time. Block time depends, because basically is how much time you are going to need divided by how much time a block is needed to be mined. So at the end, we are going to have. it's a bit convoluted, but let's calculate it.
Okay.
So the number of seconds a day has. So we have 24 hours multiplied by 60 multiplied by 60, and this is a day. Then we are going 0. It's a quarter of the day, so it's 0.25. And this is the number of seconds. Now we are going to divide it by 5, because we are in next day.
Okay.
These are the number of blocks we have in one quarter of the day. That is,
yeah,
6 hours. Okay.
Okay.
Now. This is what we have at converted time to do.
Right, yeah.
1/2. However, 1/ 1/2. And this is the alpha.
Uh-huh.
And I am going to write it the same decimals. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think that they are 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
10. One question. So half time is like the duration of the conviction you allocate on a proposal. So you stack some tokens and you have some sort of conviction on that proposal, and on a quarter of the day all that conviction decays.
When you are imagine that you are supporting a proposal.
Yeah.
And you are staking one token on one proposal. All the conviction that token will have the maximum conviction.
Yes.
It is going to take forever because it is never to reach a maximum. It's like an asian. It keeps growing and growing and growing, but there is a line that is never going to reach. And this is what we call the maximum. But it makes a kind of cure. So the first half of the conviction is going to be reached very soon. Okay? This first half is what we call half time, half life.
Half time or half life?
I think that it's half life, the technical word. It's that it's used in science a lot, because there are many natural processes that use that have that half time, that half life.
Got it.
So
the
half of your voting power is reached in that amount of time, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And the other half is going to take a lot longer.
Long time, yeah. Okay.
Oh,
and
cool.
If you wanted to know how much will cost for reaching 20%, for example, you could change that for 0.8, for example.
Okay.
It's a good idea. This is what determines. It's half-life because we have here a half.
Yeah.
This could be another fraction.
Oh, okay.
Cool.
Thanks.
The Mach ratio that we are setting up.
So we also have a weight.
The Mach ratio 0.25. So instead of 10, it's 25. And mean three fold is 0.005. That's a 5%. So at least people will need 5% of conviction to pass any group. And that's all. We can deploy that. We already set up some token some initial token holder. I think that everything is fine.
Good, yeah. So what's weight in this case? Const weight.
This is the parameter that you have to set up the conviction voting.
Mm-hmm.
But having min threshold, you can also set up weight. I mean, they are dependent. One with the other. Weight is can be better to describe some things because it's linearly dependent on the threshold.
Right.
But maybe to think on what parameter do we want is better to set up a mean threshold.
Okay.
But they are dependent using that formula.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of defining weight, it's better to define mean threshold probably.
Cool.
And do this calculation inside the smart contract too. At the end, we are going to calculate decay and weight inside the smart contract.
Yeah.
And Mach ratio, maybe we also want to do something else. The three parameters that we use to define a conviction voting are going to change.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to deploy the DAO. Let's see how it works.
Yeah. Okay.
hope that everything is updated and it works. One of the things that happened with Aragon is that dependencies changes so fast.
Yeah.
Well, it depends on a lot of dependencies. Then if you spend 6 months without updating them, they begin to not be available anymore. Or maybe there is some update on one of the dependencies that is not backwards compatible, or there may happen anything that breaks the project. And it's the same thing, but they just change there has been any update on one dependency, and then when you do a npm install again, it doesn't work. It was working, but it doesn't work anymore. This is what happened.
Yeah.
Paulo has had that problem because
too many times.
He was going to. What was the story, Paulo? You were going to present your.
Oh, my dissertation project. My final dissertation project on the university. And one week before the deadline, the dependencies broke and my project didn't work.
Oh no.
Thanks, Aragon. So yeah, I had to find some nightly version that Sam gave me, because Sam was one of my co-directors.
Uh-huh.
And but at the end they managed to fix the dependency problem and everything worked fine. But yeah, that happens basically every time you try to install dependencies on a Aragon project.
Every time. Only on the
time. Every time.
Only on the time that
it's a nightmare. But yeah.
Well, the project is growing very fast, and this is what happens. That things get broken.
I got so disappointed so many times with running Aragon apps locally. I started to learn Python because I didn't understand how to continue with the apps. You know?
Another last soul.
Yeah, I think that Python has a I don't know, I don't develop with Python so much, but npm yeah help.
I didn't understand the last part that you said.
The npm can be very rogue and Python. I think that Python doesn't have npm, at least
Python
problems.
Uses PIP.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is happening with the npm is that one dependency is different from the other dependency. It's very segmented. There are lots of libraries. And I think that it's not something that is happening with Python.
Yeah.
If you have bigger libraries in Python.
Yeah, and the documentation is amazing. You have every answer on Stack Overflow already. No need to.
Yeah.
It's like only one. Or maybe two times I had to write a question on Stack Overflow. The rest, it was like always someone had before had the same issue. So I was thinking of asking programming questions from Aragon on Stack Overflow. What do you think of that?
I don't think you're gonna receive so many answers.
But maybe, maybe I think they could, like, put some honey into it, or because it's so hard to become an Aragon programmer without help from another programmers. It's like it's not everything on Google or on the web.
I mean, for me, the best place is the help, dev help channels on Aragon, and they reply very fast.
Yeah, lately, but not
lately. Yeah,
on Discord.
Not only the core team, but another developers might help you too.
Yeah. Yeah.
I am going to deploy. See what is that? Oh,
this is what.
okay, let's begin to debug event of its file directory. Do you think that if we write that on Stack Overflow?
I if I had it, I would do it. I will do because I don't know. It's like so important.
Okay. What is happening here is that it is looking for something like build.contract and slash contracts, and it's not there. Why? Because we have to compile it first. But yeah, you have to know that
Honey template doesn't have like the script commands and the package JSON. You have to do it manually.
Then no, we can check now. Well, because it was installing Aragon Fundraising. One of the dependencies is Aragon Fundraising with all the things of Aragon Fundraising. And it is completely not needed, so.
Oh.
We have a lot of script work that we probably don't want, but it had that compiled. And also it has deploy Rinkeri, for example, but it doesn't have deploy XDAI.
Yeah, you can find it there. It's like the 9, 10 commands, I think.
Yeah, that's better. It has the factories and all that stuff.
Yeah,
that's
it compiles it for you and then execute it.
No, wait a sec. We don't have to deploy. We don't have to deploy because it's already deployed.
Already
deployed. Yeah, there is two things here. One is to compile the contracts in your machine, which is something that we did right now. So you have the ABIs, and you can play with them. Then there is that deploy of the template on XDAI parameters. But it's the deployment of the smart contract that generates the DAOs. It's the template. And then, when you do a new DAO, what you do is it's to call a script that uses that template that it has been deployed there in order to create the DAO. Does it have sense?
So you use the template deploy command or something like that to deploy a new DAO, but not this command.
I am using new DAO instead the deploy. There are two scripts. One to deploy the template, and another one is to use the template that has been deployed in order to create a DAO.
That's the new DAO.js file.
Let's see if that works. If not, we will need to deploy the template again into another contract and use that new deploy template in order to create the DAO. Let's cross fingers.
Minor problem.
The transaction has gone through.
Why are there two transactions?
Because in just one transaction, there is transactions have a gas limit.
Okay.
Are defined at the level of the network. So you cannot do so much things in just one transaction because there is that gas limit.
Okay.
So in the case of Gardens, we have four transactions.
Okay.
And you always have to be like, if you do something much further in one transaction, sometimes it says gas limit reached, and then you have to do what you do that on another transaction.
Yeah,
it's sometimes develop in Solidity is like that. It's to do ugly code just to fit the
EVM happy.
Yeah. Okay, so the problem that here we have the DAO. Now one hive.
Okay, it's annoying too.
And where do you want me to send a link?
Anywhere is fine. Gardens or hello Luigi
in cafe. Okay,
hello.
Welcome back.
Hello. In cafe.
Cool.
And when you deploy a new DAO on XDAI, it takes a little bit at the beginning. I think that the rest of SID know why, but I don't know. There is something with XDAI that it doesn't detect something, I don't remember.
So it's only the first time you made it?
Yes.
When you deployed it, I mean?
I think with the blobs that are created, I don't remember.
I mean, it's looking for the events and contracts events on the network, right?
Yes, but it's not the only problem. Maybe it's part of the problem, but it takes so long because the first time the blocks are not mined
or catch.
No, but it's not a catch problem.
Oh.
It's a problem with the network.
Because, for example, in Rinkeby, when you delete the cache, it takes a while to.
No, I'm not sure really. Maybe the cache can help too. But it should go as much faster. Because it's already there, so
loading forever.
Yeah. experience for the user to create something and then, oh, it's broken. Sometimes it takes forever.
What's that console app you have on the system?
That's the best thing ever.
That's a new one.
That's the best. You also have it. You have to activate that. That's a very interesting thing. You go to network basically. You go to help and feed.
Okay.
And you put that here, which is the hacker mode.
Oh, so it's a... Okay, I get it. It's
the
a command line on the web page.
Now, you go here, if it lets you. It's not going to let you do anything. I can show you in another... Say, honey.
No, that doesn't exist. There's only... It's done. Yeah.
So, as you can see here, it's helping you to select what commands you want. You have exec. Exec is used in order to imagine you want to create a new vesting in here in Pollinator, right? But there is no interface for vesting in Token Manager. But you have the smart contract.
It lets you call the smart contract function.
See, maybe the thing is too much, but...
I mean, you can open a new terminal and do it from there.
Okay, the idea is to use a sync vested. You go here and say exec tokens method name. For example, receiver. I want to be the receiver. Second argument. Amount. Let's say. Start is time. Cliff, vested. So you finish that in that way, and you click enter, and it tries to execute that. In that case, the only way to vest the tokens here is the aborting, I think. But it depends on the permissions.
Yeah, but yes.
Well, no one can.
No vest. One can yet. I don't know why they don't appear here. They should appear. Async. Ah, it's the async. Async role. Okay. So we should create that permission first. Which you set it here, like you set it for top. You grant permission for voting. And you select voting. And in order to do that, you have to create a vote, because when you want to create a new permission, you have to have permissions to that, which is is create permissions, and only voting right now can ask new permissions. And this is why you can use that. But also, you can add, which is using the agent. And you can use that agent, and you can say which address you want to call, and which method you want to call on that address.
Yeah.
Cool too. And there is another command that it's not listed here. but it's called install. Now you can install whatever of these applications, but you can also use, for example, transactions, whatever name your application has.
Oh, you put the registry of your app, mm-hmm. and then install it.
And then okay. what you need to have is the initialization parameters. In that case, there are no initialization parameters, and then a permissions.
And console do everything for you. Create the permissions, create the apps.
What it does is to create a vault. Let's say I am not going to do that because it's a production DAO. But what it will do is to create a vault that have the installation and also the assignation of the permissions, and everything goes bundled in an EVM script.
Okay. Who did this? One hype? The console?
No. I don't know. Gabi was involved, but I don't remember who else.
I mean, it's actually a lot of time. It's user friendly, at least more than the terminal, the command line.
Yeah.
It's nice.
Yeah.
There's also the website to install apps that you don't need the console.
Yay, we have a DAO!
On next slide.
Wow, we have a... what?
Yep. Quickly! It means some tokens. Wait, so... hi.
Okay. A rate of 2%.
Same. It means some tokens.
A lot of tokens. It's okay. I was expecting not to have that much. And it is issuing inside the vault, I guess. We can see that here. No, we can see that here. Yeah, that vault here. We just have one, and it's here.
So we just deploy the hunt template, right?
Yes. With a token that it's called Token Engineering Commons Test Token.
Okay.
And I don't know who is that holder. Don't worry. Don't want that holder to have that amount. I don't have access to that account. It's a problem. I have put it up here. And maybe I have. I should have. Okay, it's account 5. Okay, it's a public address. It's the one of the Aragon addresses. I guess I could connect now. And what is going on? It doesn't work really well. It's like it's the last part of the address is not work, is not there. It begins well, right? But then the last part is not working. I don't know what happened. I think that I it must go inside of quotes. If not, it breaks. Oh. That's an important thing to have. I have to redeploy.
How much XDAI did you spend on deploying there?
Not sure. It's not much. This is the gas used. I don't know which is the gas price that I'm using. So we have that new DAO created, and it's going to take a while until it is created, it is available, but we have Honeypot now. It takes, I don't know if it's an environment variable or not, I think so. React app name of the app. React app org address. This React app org address is the part that we have to, or we can set it up in networks.js. Let's see what it has. We can set it up as environment variable or here in networks. Maybe inside config.
So we're trying to add our DAO now, right? To this template.
What?
We're trying to add our deployed DAO to the honeypot.
Yes.
From then. Okay.
I think what I can do is to fork the honeypot into the TEC, and then what we can do is to as a group customize the honeypot, which is going to be right now like that. I guess that what we have to do is to change the
right.
The logo, that other logo. This is hardcoded, and we should get the name of the token from the DAO itself, if it's possible. Change that to
that's hard coded.
Yeah, I think that's well, maybe that not, and that yes. Some of them, I'm almost sure that some of them are hard coded. The token name is available somewhere. I have to go for it. Also, there is that ticker. We will not have a price for that.
Yeah, I worked a bit with that.
up something for now, and then we can use the conversion to XDAI in the bonding curve. Does it have sense for you?
Yeah.
Also, here we have that get honey that we brought, that it goes to honey swap right now.
So we need to fork honey swap too and...
No. We will probably these links up here has to be changed, or we'll need to decide together what to do with those. And also we have.
And what about the general style, the colors, the fonts? Are we gonna change it or?
Yes, we have to change them.
Mm-hmm.
And we, there is a, and the one that is used now is One Hive UI, that it's a fork from Aragon UI. Yeah. And probably what we are going to do is a fork from One Hive UI to TEC UI.
Oh my, okay.
So it's the same thing, but with different colors and different things.
I mean, Aragon UI should be more customized.
Maybe.
Because having three component libraries that basically have the same components, it's a bit...
No, it's okay. It could be different, but... You are just defining your library with your. You don't have to change that in many places. It's just one thing, one dependency that you inject, and you decide what to do with that, with just that dependency.
Oh.
It's a. It's not that. You are injecting. It's a dependency injection. It's a pattern that is good.
Okay.
Of course, it could have more parameters, and you could define more colors, maybe, or something. Maybe it's already possible. I don't know. But it's okay as it is. We can just fork it and then inject it into the honey pot. I don't know. I was going to tell Vivian if she wanted to take into that, but if you can coordinate with her and have it during these 2 days, we can deploy it and we can point people here. Who would you like to be working on that specific thing?
I don't have no problem. I would like to do that with Vivian.
Okay.
Do we have a task created on the GitHub board, I think, about the things we have to change? I mean, I know we have to change the token, the get the data from the smart contracts, about the token symbol and all that, but do we have like a list of tasks about what?
No, somebody has to do that.
We should create something about some sort of list of all the things we have to change.
If you want, I mean, you will see. I don't want to do the list. If you want to take that task, probably Vivian also wants to take that task. you can coordinate on creating that list, and I don't want to, I mean, I would prefer you to self-organize.
Okay.
But of course, you can ask me if you need. Oh, there is a proposal to top up the faucet. It's going to pass today.
Yeah, I put up that vote.
Wow. Wow.
All right. One of the first proposals.
Wow.
Great. Congratulations.
Thanks, guys. It's just to have a bit more money from the... What's that? Not much. It's like a bit more.
It's going to be a lot more.
Yeah, it's about double of them. So far, I think it was like $2 in honey. Now it's going to be $4 in honey again.
Yeah.
That's cool.
What do you mean?
Awesome.
Okay. So, I am forgetting that now. And if you want to change that, I think that it's here. I'm not really sure. You can change that here.
Yeah.
And that's everything you have to do. And cool. Then the rest of the things.
Now we can work on the front end.
And let's work on that on... never know. If we should be working on that on token engineering or on gardens.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe gardens are good. Whatever you work on that, just ping Vivian and me, and the rest who wants to work on that.
Cool.
Okay.
Okay. Probably Paolo also won. But with Paolo we were working on other stuff, and I don't know. Whatever. Just being people.
Yeah, we can just keep chatting also in the gardens, Swan's Discord chat if you want to also keep each other up to date.
Okay. That's
so that's all, right? Or I mean, do we have to? There is something more we need to see, or
no? I think that we can continue these days.
Okay.
I am going to forward that, and if you want to do some changes, you can on it.
Sure.
Okay.
This was very educational.
Thank you, Sam. Thanks a lot for doing this. It's amazing. What do you, if the recording went well, what do you want me to do with it, to share it with you? Like, I can upload it to my YouTube channel if you want, and list it, and send the link to all of you if you want, or I can put it up publicly, or I can send it to whoever.
It would be nice to have like a TAC Commons YouTube channel, like tech, something like that.
There is already one. You can contact Grid, you can contact Optimus, who is managing the YouTube channel, and he will upload it.
Okay, I didn't hear the name properly, but if you can send me the, or I don't know.
Septimus.
Alright, thanks guys.
Hey guys.
Thanks.
The honeypot is already forked here.
Okay.
You can call it another thing like its interface or
nice.
It's interface. Hey guys.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Bye.
See you guys.
Bye guys.